Among other things, 2020 has been a fairly bad year when it comes to new TVs. We haven't seen any truly new technological innovations on production models, and most of the releases were just a rehash of last year's models. Since new products are planned way ahead, it's clear that the reason for this is not the whole pandemic situation, but simply some laziness on manufacturers' part, like they're all waiting for mini LED, QD OLED, and other new technologies in order to offer something new and better. This was especially evident with Korean duo, which are still leaders in TV domain, so the Samsung for the second year in a row has made a step back with their 4K QLED models in an attempt to push 8K, while LG has made two steps back with NanoCell and offered pretty much the same thing when it comes to OLED. In this situation, Chinese manufacturers took initiative, most notably TCL and Hisense, which along with Samsung are the founders of Quantum Dot Alliance, and made their new models a pretty significant step up from last year. While the TCL offered a very good mini LED, which unfortunately is not available outside of the US, Hisense came out with a few very interesting models, H9G and H8G for US, and U7QF and U8QF for European and other markets. Last year, we got to test Hisense U8B, which we considered a best buy among true HDR TVs. Both of this year's models, intended for the global market, are expected to bring improved image quality, so we were impatiently waiting to get our hands on them and see if they are as good as they look on paper. U8QF should arrive soon, and this time we're taking a look at U7QF in a 65-inch size. It's a Quantum Dot technology-equipped 4K TV with full array local dimming backlight rated at 700 nits, which sounds like a really good deal for around €880 for 65 inches or €660 for 55-inch version. Let's see if it performs as good as it sounds. Design-wise, U7QF looks a lot like this year's Hisense A7500F, except that the bottom bezel is chrome instead of gunmetal shade. The stand is made of a single piece of metal and looks better than the usual pair of tiny legs on the opposite sides of the TV, though it requires just a bit less space on your TV stand, unless you decide to wall-mount the TV via VESA 300x200 mount, which is also an option. The VESA mount holes are what Hisense traditionally uses to mount the handles, which is our favorite detail since it makes getting the TV out of the box so much easier. The screen bezels are very thin since the panel is practically inserted into a metal shell, which looks good but also makes the TV impeccably sturdy. Beside the shell, on the back of the TV there's also a plastic extension which houses the connectors and electronics. In a typical Hisense fashion, the connectors are separated into three sections, so the one on the side available for easy access holds most important ones like free HDMI 2.0, 2 USB 2.0, optical audio out, and antenna and satellite connectors. A small section on the back holds composite AV inputs, LAN and service ports, as well as an additional HDMI, while the one accessible from the top is just a CI plus 1.4 card slot. The panel on this TV is 65 inches in size, 4K of course, and VA type, which offers not the best viewing angles, but also a far superior native contrast and black levels compared to an IPS. It is a panel with 8-bit plus FRC color display, which according to our measurements, thanks to the use of quantum dot filtering, is able to display 90.5% of DCI-P3 color gamut, in line with the best models currently available. Still, true 10-bit panels offer finer gradients between different color shades, but in real use, this is something that you probably won't notice that much. The backlight is direct LED and supports between 32 and 96 local dimming zones, depending on the panel size you choose. The 65-inch version, of course, supports all 96 zones. Interestingly, backlight brightness is rated at 700 nits max and 450 nits typical, but in our measurements, in SDR mode with 25% coverage, TV was able to reach an amazing 1027.5 nits in dynamic mode, which practically makes it the brightest TV in SDR we've tested so far. This year, Hisense obviously went all out on brightness since the aforementioned H9G and U8QF have also gained a reputation of really bright TVs, but still, this is beyond what we expected, especially since last year's U8B was able to reach 1000 nits only in very specific cases. High brightness combined with a high native contrast of a VA panel, as well as an effective full area local dimming, gives this TV an absolutely impressive contrast, especially for its class, which in dynamic mode we measured at staggering 24,464 to 1. If there was any doubt whether the U8B was a true HDR TV, there sure is none here, since the true HDR is attainable when the screen can display 14 f-stops of dynamic range, each of which represents twice the brightness, which translates to a contrast requirement of 16,000 to 1. Speaking of HDR, U7QF supports HDR10, HLG, and Dolby Vision formats, and thanks to Quantum Dot and lots of local dimming zones, HDR content looks really good, far better than on any similarly priced models of the same size, so we must say that the Hisense has made a quantum leap this year. The most accurate display is available in Cinema Day and Cinema Night modes, with a measured delta E deviation of 2.4 and 2.5, well under the limit of 3 for most shades except a few yellow, orange and red. Now, another important factor for a good visual impression is the image processing, which unfortunately is not on the same level as the panel and the hardware specs. This is something Koreans still do much better, well, South ones at least, not sure about the North. Upscaling the lower resolution videos is good enough, while MEMC or motion processing comes with several predefined modes which are not ideally tuned, so depending on the type of content you're watching and whether it's a 24fps movie or 30 or 60fps video, you will have to switch modes to find the one that works the best for that particular source. With the right combination, you will be able to get a smooth motion even though the panel refreshes at 60Hz, but we did notice that sometimes when the scene changes, the algorithm has trouble recognizing that and can cause stutter trying to smooth out the sudden change. MEMC also allows you to fine-tune the de-judder and the blur sliders in custom mode, so with a bit of experimenting, you will be able to find combinations that suit your taste for movies and sports and save them as part of a picture profile. TV also comes with a clear motion option, which activates the backlight strobing between each frame and greatly improves panel response time and reduces blur. It works especially well with motion set to smooth, but not well at all with some other MEMC presets. It also causes the image to be much darker, which considering the abundant brightness would not be a problem if there wasn't for a visible flicker, which can be unpleasant depending on how sensitive your eyes are and how bright your room is, so you're likely to use this option only occasionally for gaming when you really need the best response time. Speaking of gaming, 65U7QF also has a superbly low input lag of 10.5 milliseconds, in game mode of course, which you can activate independently no matter which picture preset you're using. You can connect the source with a 4K resolution and 60Hz refresh rate, which is going to be enough for most games, even for a PlayStation 5 or a new Xbox, since even with all the optimization, it is hard to expect that such a hardware can push 4K 120 when even RTX 3090 is unable to unless you're playing Pac-Man. As for the sound of this TV, it is solid and sounds the best in theater mode with Dolby Atmos on. The sound stage is very good, a frequency balance is fair, with just enough bass for the music and movies to sound convincing, even if it does not extend into the sub-bass range. Smart functions are provided by an updated VIDAA U 4.0 platform, which we talked about previously in our A7500F review, and which offers an improved user interface and user experience compared to previous Hisense TVs. In the middle of the screen, there are two lines of app icons with usual video and music streaming services. Above those lines is a large banner which will display the content suggestions related to an app you select, while on the bottom there are additional lines with various lists of music, sports, kids, gaming and other content. The selection of available apps is not spectacular, but you do get most of the important ones, along with some pretty basic 8-bit games, which is something that, among the competition, only Android TV does better. Controlling the TV is done via compact remote with nicely designed keys with clear and precise click, though you can also use the Remote Now mobile app as well as a remote network service. All in all, Hisense 65U7QF is a TV with by far the best hardware specs in its class, with an image processing which is not on the same level, though it is also priced significantly lower than the TVs with similar hardware specs. This is a TV for all those who want an undoubtedly good image quality for watching 4K and HDR content, even for large screen gaming, but don't want to spend too much cash. The compromise is in narrower viewing angles, 60Hz screen refresh rate and motion algorithms which take some tweaking, but we feel that for around 660 euros for 55-inch and 880 euros for 65-inch version, it does not take away from the good overall impression and that those who can live with those compromises will get a very high value for their money. That would be all for this review, but we invite you to share your thoughts on this TV in the comment section and let us know how you feel about this model. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like and consider subscribing to our channel for more interesting tech content. You are watching Benchhouse, my name is Ivan and I'll see you next time.